What do you think what I said so far? Does it make sense?
Yeah, I get that. I just, before, so like a week ago, I spoke to my friend who was a Muslim.
Sorry, I just want to, yeah, I have many things holding.
Go yeah, on. He was a Muslim and then he left the religion. And I told him, oh, maybe I'm a little bit interested in Islam. And I told him, like, some of my questions. And then his views were like, he was saying, when Muhammad got the messages from God, he, like, how can you say that he didn't change and manipulate them before he put them in? Told them to people and made it into the Quran. Like, how do you know he didn't change his opinion? Like, put his opinion into what came from Allah.
Yeah, that's firstly, we have to establish that this man is a trustworthy, truthful, yeah, honest. Okay. Secondly, I'll just give you an example of Muhammad who was not manipulating. One of them, the story where he could have told to the woman, he could have told her, Allah told me. Did he say that? He didn't say that. You with me? So we can see many incidents where Muhammad, if he was a liar, he would have said something with his own opinion. For example, the Quran is a proof that it's not from Prophet Muhammad, because there's verse in the Quran rebuking Prophet Muhammad for making some mistakes. Hang on. Rebuking is the correct word to use? Is it itab in Arabic? I hope I'm translating correct. Itab, Allah, not hardly, but Allah correcting him. Hang on, if it's Muhammad making this Quran, why is gonna make himself look he's making mistakes? Do you understand? That's why Ummuna Aisha, his wife, she said there's many verses to prove that Muhammad was an honest man. One of the verses, Allah said, Ya ayyuhan nabiyyu, balligh ma unzila ilayka min rabbika. O Muhammad, convey from that which you have from your Lord. And one of them, there's a verse which our mother Aisha, his wife, may Allah be pleased with her, she said, this verse is so clear, Prophet Muhammad did not manipulate. Which verse? Prophet Muhammad, he had a son called Usama, Zayd ibn Haritha. Afwan means sorry, okay? In Arabic.
Afwan, yeah.
Yeah, you know it, okay. Zayd ibn Haritha. He was married to a woman called Zaynab bint Jahsh. Zayd ibn Haritha, he was his stepson before Islam. Adopted son. Islam came to remove this. Yeah, take care of the orphans, treat them nice, but they're not your son. They have their own parents. So Zayd ibn Haritha, and by the way, to mention another story, Zayd ibn Haritha, when his parents came to look for him, when they found out he's in Mecca, they came to him, they said to him, we are your parents, let's come. He said, no. He said, what I saw from this man, I will never exchange him with no one. They said, Zayd, how dare you? This is, we are your parents, your family. He said, no, I'm not going to leave this man. His truthfulness is trustworthy. So, again, this is another story to show this man is a truthful person. How a man is going to choose someone, and he was not forcing him or something, he was taking care of him. Anyway, when he was married to Zayd ibn Haritha, was married to Zainab ibn Jahsh. They had problems. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah told him, they're going to get divorced, and you're going to marry Zainab ibn Jahsh. But at that time, from the Arab pagans' teaching, which has nothing to do from God, that you're not allowed to get married to the ex-wife of your adopted son. But Allah removed, he's not his son, yes? So even Prophet Muhammad was finding it very hard to deal with it. Allah revealed the verse that Prophet Muhammad is hesitating to mention it. Wait. If I'm a liar, because we have to understand, there's no one worse in lying than someone claiming to be a prophet of God, you know? Regardless how much you lie, if you claim to be a prophet of God, you are the worst liar. Because you are saying, do this because God told me.
How do you know that, because I know you believe that when Jesus comes back to earth, that's the day, is that?
From the size of the hour.
Yeah.
So
what if somebody comes out to you and is like, I'm Jesus?
That's a good point, but we have criteria.
What's
in the
criteria?
Quran, in the Sunnah, the criteria is Jesus will come from Syria, will be descending. He will see descending with the angels holding him. Also, he has a curly hair, okay? And his hair is like just have ablution, okay? And there's many, many signs before that.
So we have
ablution, wudu. It's like he just had the water, you understand? So Allah, so there is. That's why don't get it wrong, you know? There's people claim to be Jesus before.
Yeah.
But remember, Allah exposed them. And one of them, he was in the time of the Khilaf al-Islamiyyah. He claimed to be Jesus. So they took him to the leader. The leader said, I'm going to kill you. He said, no, I'm joking, I'm not Jesus. He changed, you know? So Jesus, when he comes, there's before Mahdi comes. So there's many signs, you know. Even some people claim to Mahdi, huh?
After the Mahdi before. No, Mahdi before.
Yeah, that's what I said. All right. I said Mahdi before. Yeah. So what we're saying, so there is, alhamdulillah, and Allah exposed them. Because remember, look, something I was going to mention to establish, Allah is the most wise, you know. The most wise will never leave us with confusion. Yes, Allah will allow some people to, as a test, to see who's going to stand firm or not. But Allah eventually will expose them. At the time of Muhammad, والسلام, there were other people claiming to be a prophet of God. But Allah exposed them and humiliated them. Except Prophet Muhammad. Did you know there's a verse in the Quran? Allah mentioned the prophet, this verse was revealed. When the Prophet Muhammad was in a battlefield. Yeah? And his companions used to guard him outside his tent. The verse was revealed that Allah will protect you, O Muhammad. He came out, he told his companions, leave me. Imagine in a time of battle. His enemies, they waited for any opportunity to kill him. And he said, leave me. And Allah revealed the verse in the Quran that, O Muhammad, you're not going to want to die. And you will not be killed until you convey the message. When this verse was revealed, and Allah will protect you. When this verse was revealed, Prophet Muhammad was not behind hiding in the fortress. Because I can hide in my house for 25 years. And I said, look, Allah told me, and I have many enemies outside, by the way. Yeah? And Allah told me, I'm not going to be killed. But I'm hiding. But imagine that Allah told me, I'm not going to be killed. And guess where I am? I'm in a battle fighting with the swords. And I'm telling you, I'm going to convey my message. And historically, from Muslim sources and non-Muslim sources, that what has occurred with the Prophet Muhammad. Before he died, Islam was completed. He looked at his companions leading the prayer. This is not a statement of someone is a normal man. You understand? Because when a people lie to be a prophet of God, they always say something vague or they hide and so on. But what Prophet Muhammad said and the prophecy that came with and so on is so perfect. So if Prophet Muhammad wants to manipulate, there's many situations when we see that he was good for him, but what he did, he said something which goes against him as a human being. From a human angle, like example, if I'm a liar, I'm not going to start correcting myself, because I think if I do correct myself, remember these people believe I'm a prophet of God. They're going to think, oh, this guy is lying, man. Like, even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, in Surah Al-Haqqa, وَلَوْ تَقَوَّلَ عَلَيْنَا بَعْضَ الْأَقَاوِيلِ لَأَخَذْنَا مِنْهُ بِالْيَمِينِ ثُمَّ لَقَطَعْنَا مِنْهُ الْوَتِينِ فَمَا مِنْكُم مِّنْ أَحَدٍ عَنْهُ حَاجِزِينَ. Allah mentioned, oh Muhammad, if you make up anything about Allah, Allah will take you, severely and destroy you. Meaning, straight away, as for him dying after, by poison or whatever, this is not the verse. The verse means straight away. By the fact that Prophet ﷺ and Prophet Muhammad ﷺ said, Islam will spread far east, far west. Historically, Islam spread all the way to China and all the way to Andalusia, Spain, even now America and so on. Again, you know, that's why as a Muslim, we don't believe Islam is the truth because I had a dream. In my house, I was sleeping. I said, sister, believe Islam is the truth. Why, Shamsi, brother Shamsi? Because I had a dream, our Prophet Muhammad came to me. Or one day I was in prison, you know, I saw Jesus or Muhammad. No, we don't work like that. Alhamdulillah. This personal experience, okay? But Islam is based upon universal proofs, which you and I and all of us here, we can analyze and come to conclusion. That must be the truth. Anyone with a sound reasoning inclined towards it. So what this person said, the biography of Prophet Muhammad and the Quran refute him. About Prophet ﷺ manipulating or adding, no. You can see clearly, even there is a verse, Allah said, عَبَسَ وَتَوَلَّ أَنْ جَاءَهُ الْأَعْمَى وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ لَعَلَّهُ يَزَّكَّى أَوْ يَذَّكَّرُ فَتَنْفَأَهُ الذِّكْرَى أَمَّا مَنِ اسْتَغْنَى فَأَنْتَ لَهُ تَصَدَّى وَمَا عَلَيْكَ أَلَّا يَزَّكَّى وَأَمَّا مَنْ جَاءَكَ يَسْعَى وَهُوَ يَخْشَى فَأَنْتَ عَنْهُ تَلَهَّى كَلَّا إِنَّهَا تَذْكِرَى. Until the end of the verses. Allah said about a man, so what happened? A man came to Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, he was a blind man. His companion. Prophet Muhammad ﷺ was busy preaching to the Arab pagans, to the head, to the leaders. So he came to him and he wanted to ask him. Prophet Muhammad's like, wait, you know, because his follower, wait, I'm busy with them. Allah sent the verses correcting. And Prophet Muhammad said, you should not do that. Those guys, they're not going to listen to you. They are stubborn. Focus on those who are seeking the truth. If he's a liar, why is he going to mention this verse? He's going to hide it. Or we're going to change it. He didn't. So that's why one of our scholars, there's two of them, Ibn Hazm al-Zahiri, may Allah have mercy upon him, Ibn Taymiyyah al-Harrani, may Allah have mercy upon him, he said anyone study the biography and the history of Prophet Muhammad with sincerity, they will come to the conclusion this man must be the Prophet of the Most High. Make sense? Alhamdulillah. So become Muslim, accept Islam, truth.
One more thing.
Okay, one more thing, accept Islam.
And then I'll probably need to go.
Okay, no, 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 to go, accept. Yeah, we're going to compromise. Yeah, Alhamdulillah.